Not toward me. Oh my God.
Ice cold.
Pick one. Don't look.
No match.
Not a match.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Come if you want to play.
Oh man, Howie, be careful.
Guys?
Bye, Howie.
He's still here.
It's moving.
Match the piece.
Match the piece. With that?
Ooh.
Is that good?
Howie.
Oh. I feel like I got stabbed in the back. How did...
Taking the ashes.
He's gone for now. But he already knows your name, Howie.
Not my name? Oh, did you guys hear that? There's a voice saying Howie. Just me? I swear to you. Okay, all right. I'm gonna just.
Take the knives out.
Oh no! It says I'm coming for you, Howie. Where'd she go? Oh my gosh!
Where did she go?
Great.
What happened? I don't.
Is it over?
I'm coming for you, Howie. Okay.
Are we at the end of that?
Thank you.
Is everyone as confused as I am?
I don't know what's going on.
Apparently somebody's coming for me, so I would like to get the judging out of the way and so that I can leave.
I don't know what to say. Has it finished?
No, I don't think it's finished.
I'm finished.
Has it finished?
I really, legitimately, I'm not kidding. I'm telling you that I'm terrified.
Terrified of what?
Read the note!
I mean, Howie's terrified because someone is coming for
I
Howie,
was poked in the back. I was
good.
Stabbed in the back.
We're good.
He knows my name, and he's coming for me. Is that judging? Have we done what we're paid to do?
Yes, yes, very good.
Well, good. Let's move on with the show, then. Let's see another act, something that'll get rid of...
That gets rid of the juju vibe.
Yeah.
From BGT.
I'm Howie.
Top. Hello.
Hello, Simon. Do you remember me?
Of course I remember you. Forget you and I have met. Tell us who you are. What's the dream?
Okay, my name is Keiji Wasaki, and I have been traveling with bicycle. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here.
Okay, so why are you here?
No, because it's a big, big opportunity to show my magic all over the world.
All right, good luck, Keiji.
Yeah, thank you. Arigato gozaimasu.
Arigato.
Yep.
He's already making me laugh.
He's very funny.
Here we go.
Hello, Simon.
Hi, Keiji.
Hello, Howie.
Hello.
Okay, yep, I have two handkerchiefs here. Okay, please.
Okay.
Could you make a knot? Is it possible?
It is possible.
Yeah, yes, please make a knot.
What you're doing.
Okay. Yes. Very tight, please.
Okay.
Very tight, please.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Okay. Then, okay, one more time, please.
Another
make
knot.
Make sure tight, okay. Yes.
And you dance, too.
Yeah. Very tight, please.
I know.
Very tight, huh?
I'm doing it tight.
Simon, do you want to check it? Please check it. We do. Yes, put boss tight, the shirt, the tight. And it's very tight.
That's a knot.
Okay, that's a knot. Now, usually it's how long does it take to untie it?
2 minutes, 3 minutes.
No, maybe 3 days. But give me a hand like this.
What?
Open like this.
It is.
Then just put it. Hold here. Hold,
okay.
Hold. Yes.
Hold it.
But don't move. It's very dangerous. Okay?
Okay.
Don't move.
Okay.
What the? Open your hand.
What happened?
Open your hand. Here you go.
Oh!
Next magic is this one.
Whoa.
I need a LED light from here.
What?
Oh, sorry, here. No, Heidi, in here. Sorry, excuse me. No, Simon, open your mouth. I get out.
Like
a little bit like this. Okay, now.
No. I love this guy.
Heidi, could you come join me to the stage?
Yes.
Thank you.
Arigato.
Yes.
Sorry. Yes, my last trick is this. This is what? Blind hood. So can you see anything?
Well, now I can. You want me to put it on?
Yeah. No, I can't see it.
No, okay. I can't see through it.
Okay.
Okay.
Now I put this like this.
Oh, you want it.
Yes. Now okay. I make like this. Then give me a finger like this. Is it okay? Can I touch this?
You can touch it.
Yes.
I'm not like Howie.
Okay. Sorry. Then I have a ring. Okay. Can I put one this here? Okay. Please don't move. It's a very difficult magic trick.
I won't move.
Okay.
Okay.
Give me a ring. Okay. Please don't move. It's incredibly difficult. This ring from here. Without watching. 1, 2, 3. Oh! Is it flying? I can see it.
It's spinning.
Okay, now it's just like this, okay? Uncle, also like this. Okay? Now it's a passing.
Wow! That is weird!
Heidi, don't move!
I'm not moving!
Huh? It's a Dirigat Wada!
Oh my goodness!
Amazing. How far did you go at BGT?
Semi-final. But the judge's choice was not me.
Right, they didn't
choose. I remember.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Simon was there.
Is the idea that you want to redeem yourself?
Yes, of course.
Because I think the super fans are going to love you. I love
you.
Yeah, I loved you already when it came onto the stage. You're super excited, which is getting me excited too, because you're like high speed and you're moving things around. Then I was right there with this ring, was amazing.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
Well, yeah, I mean, look, I've always liked you because a lot of magicians do take themselves very seriously on this show. And they are quite boring with their little card tricks and stuff like that. You, however, have a personality. People are gonna like you. Let's see what happens. He's funny.
Not only is he funny, the magic is amazing.
Yeah,
that trick with
good.
The ring was amazing.
Wow!
Hi.
What is your name?
My name is Bryn Cummings, and I'm a ventriloquist.
How old are you?
I'm 12.
Where are you from?
We're from Paw Paw, Michigan.
How did you get into doing this? How did you know you could do this?
Well, it was actually, I remember seeing Darcy Lynn on AGT, and that inspired me. I literally looked at my parents as soon as I saw it, and I went, that's what I'm gonna do.
Aww.
So.
And look at you now, right here in front of us. That's amazing. What are you gonna do if you win $1 million?
I mean, it's a big thing, but probably I'd like to follow in Darcy's footsteps and start touring, to get like a tour bus, and I also really want a bearded dragon.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're ready, go ahead.
All right, Penelope, it's our big moment. Are you ready for me to cue the music? I don't want to sing anymore. What? This is what we've practiced for weeks. I've been thinking about it, and it's been done. They want to see something else, something new. But we haven't practiced anything else. What's your plan? I've got it! Mentalism!
Mentalism?
Wait, what?
I don't mind, Reed. Quit playing around. Let's just sing the song. Trust me. Take me down to the judges. Is that allowed?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
So
good. Good.
I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, stop worrying. Seriously, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. It's okay, we'll use a deck of cards. Check your pocket. Wait, what? Ta-da! Heidi,
yes.
I'd like you to cut the deck one time. Howie, I'd like you to take the top card.
All right.
Vrin, look away and close your eyes. Show me the card. I will send my thoughts to Drin using my brilliant mental powers. What do I do now? Just concentrate. What comes to mind? A migraine. Drin! Okay, I'm focused. I see. I think it's black. That's it. Keep thinking. It's a club. Is it the Seven of Clubs? Open your eyes. Oh my gosh! What?
That's amazing. That's crazy.
Judges, in a moment, we're going to go back on stage. That as we do. Sophia.
Hi.
Please take out any item from your purse. The key that hidden there now.
Okay.
Simon, please run out into the audience and grab an object. Any object from anyone. Yep, in the audience. And judges, don't let us see what you picked. Do not let us see what you picked.
I'll give it
back. Let's make this a little more interesting. Terry, can you bring out the blindfold? Blindfold? Terry, inspect the blindfold. Hold it up to the light. Can you see through it?
No, I can't.
Perfect. Please put it on the ring.
Okay.
Make it nice and tight. Nice and tight. Perfect. Perfect. Thank you, Terry. You can go. You can leave now. Thank you so much. You're gonna figure out what objects the judges are holding. Sophia, hold your object up into the air. Drin, clear your mind. So Drin, what do you see?
I see it's a food. It has some sugar in it. It might be like a good treat. Maybe you leave it when Santa comes. Is it a cookie?
Sophia, what was your object?
It's an oatmeal cookie!
Oh my gosh! Since you're doing so well, you're gonna try this one solo.
Penelope, come on, I need your help.
Fine, here's a clue. Simon's object can fit inside of this room. Penelope, come on. Wait, I'm getting something. It's an accessory. You might wear it on your ankle. No, you wear it on your wrist. Is it an Apple Watch?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh my gosh! Wow! Thank you, everyone.
That's amazing.
It's so great to see you right up close, how good you're doing it. I loved it.
Thank you so much.
This is the season of mashups. The fact that you did magic or mentalism and ventriloquism at the same time, you're amazing, young
lady.
Thank
you so much.
Yes, yes.
I loved it too, because you really figured out like a perfect little act for yourself. You're part comedian too. I thought it was a lot of fun. Well done.
Thank you so much.
When did you realize that you have magic powers?
When I was about 9 years old, I would say.
That's cool. You are so talented, so charming. People are gonna root for you. You did something we've never seen before. And for me, you never want to see the same thing again, but not quite as good. You want to see it better or different, and that's what you did.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to vote. Sophia.
I'm going to give you your first yes.
Second yes.
Third yes.
Four yeses!
You did it! You did it!
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
What is your name?
My name is Ryland.
How old are you?
I'm 10 years old.
And where are you from?
I'm from England.
So Ryland, okay. Oh yes, he's from England, we know. What is your talent, young man?
Well, I'm a magician.
Ooh.
Wow.
How long you've been doing that?
Since I was 2, so 8 years.
Wow.
At 2?
I was born with magical powers, and my dad is a magician, and he gave me some of the magical powers that he didn't need anymore.
Wow. Okay. And what about the $1 million? If you get it, what would you do with that?
I'll give some to my mom, my sister, and my dad, and spend the rest on Legos.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. Let's see what you've got tonight.
Thank you. tonight, I would like you to help me create a brand new magic word.
A magic word?
But first, I have gifts. You see, I love drawing and colouring in, and I've drawn you each a picture to look at later. This one's for you, Howie.
All right.
This one's for you, Heidi.
Thank you.
This one's for you, Sophia, and this one's for you, Simon. Now, don't peek inside the envelopes. Don't let anyone else touch them. We'll get back to them later. What you're about to see is amazing, but I can't do it on my own. I need help. Luckily, I have lots of friends that love magic just like me.
Oh, hello there. Hi, friends.
We got a lot of friends.
Wow. I'll let each of you to pick one of my friends, pick one of the numbers, and I'll place it in this holder. You get to choose which position it goes in. There are multiple combinations, and the choices are all yours. We'll start with you, Howie. Please name one of my friends.
Me? Mark.
And would you like the number 7 or 23?
I'll take 7, it's lucky.
And where would you like it to go, 1, 2, 3 or 4?
First, because I'm first.
Okay, so number 1. Heidi, it's your turn.
I choose
Would you like 11 or 26?
11.
And where would you like that to go, 2, 3 or 4?
4.
Thank you, Heidi. Sophie, it's your turn. Which of my friends would you like?
Skylar.
And would you like 24 or 10?
10.
And where would you like it to go? 2 or 3?
2.
Thank you, Sophia. And Simon, which of my friends would you like?
Jordan.
Jordan. And would you like 1 or 15? 1. And we'll try something a little bit different with you. Would you like to put it in last position or swap it out for another one? Okay.
He's taking my position.
Okay. Thanks, Simon. Now, let's look at the drawings you didn't use. As you can see, they're all different. We've got things like Lego, dragons, we've got burgers. So they're all different, yeah?
Yes.
Let's look at the drawings you did choose. You chose a snake, a slice of lime, a house, and some mountains. Each of you had a free choice of which drawing you wanted, and more importantly, where to put it. The snake looks like an S, the lime looks like a C, the house looks like an A, and the mountains look like an M. That spells the word scam, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I said that earlier, we're gonna create a brand new magic word. That can be our magic word. Everyone shout scam as loud as they can on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3.
Scam!
But what if I told you that we knew what the magic word would be before you even picked it? At the beginning of my act, I gave you each a drawing to hold on to. I'd like to take the drawing out of the envelope and show it to everyone. As you can see, they match. Now, as well as having something on the front of their t-shirt, my friends also had something on the back. Look. Word equals scam.
Wow.
Now, look. Okay, so I'm at AGT. I'm gonna go in, do what I need to do, get out as fast as I can. Okay, let's go. I can't believe I'm actually inside the AGT theatre. Right, there's a desk. Better be quick, can't get caught.
What is he doing?
Something there. Oh God, Simon's gonna hate this. What's that? Oh my God, I've got one. Come on. Now, you're probably wondering what I did at the desk, Simon. Well, hopefully you're not too mad. Watch this.
It says scam everywhere.
Look, scam, 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 scam. Sorry, Simon.
Whoa.
Thank you.
Hello. What's your name?
Magic Mike Jacobson.
Magic Mike Jacobson. So you're going to be doing magic.
That's right.
Well, what a coincidence to have that name and to be
pretty
doing what
convenient.
You do.
Pretty convenient. Yeah. The movie was loosely based on my life.
Okay. Yeah. How long have you been doing magic?
I like did magic everywhere I could, from like my home to barbershops and everywhere in between, and eventually kind of just like rose and rose and rose, and would love to keep doing it, you know? So that's perfect.
Okay. And how old are you?
36.
36. And where are you from?
LA.
And how do you make a living? Do you make a living doing magic?
Not yet. I work in advertising by day, but this performance will determine whether I can quit.
Oh.
So we'll see what happens.
No pressure.
Yeah, no big deal. But actually a huge deal for me.
Well, let's see what you do. Are you nervous?
Exactly, let's see.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous. I'm also just excited to be here.
We'll wish you the best of luck, buddy.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I'm going to share something with you all tonight that every magician has, but no magician will show you for some reason. It's this. It's an invisible deck of cards. It's a bit hard to see in this light. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to burn the invisible deck from 52 all the way down to 1. At the end, Simon, you're going to be a hero, as you always are in my heart. And you're going to save one of the remaining cards from burning, but it depends on what Heidi and Sophia decide. Heidi, take that match. I don't want you to strike it and stare into the flame. Let's just say there's two groups, number cards and face cards. We need to decide whether you want to start to burn all the numbers or all the faces. Blow it out when you're ready.
Am I telling you?
Yes, please.
All the faces.
The faces are now on the fire. You can pass the box over to Sophia. Sophia, take your match, okay? Left in the fire, we've got jacks, queens, kings. Okay, the only way to divide those up would be, yeah, men and women. I want you to burn that match. And tell us, do you want to burn all the men, or do you want to burn all the women to do a crisp?
Oh, the men.
That was a very quick decision. You go ahead, you blow it out. And you can pass that to Simon. You're going to save one of the remaining cards from burning. All we have left are the four queens. Queen of hearts, queen of spades, queen of clubs, queen of diamonds. We're going to light that match. And whenever you're ready, blow it out. I want you to draw with that match the suit of the queen that you want to save. Hearts, spades, clubs, or diamonds. Is that a diamond? Here's the thing, are you sure? Simon, if you shake the matchbox, do you hear something in there? Open that up for us. Because in all of your hands the entire time, there's been nothing but one card sitting inside there, protected by a paperclip. I want to make sure, singed, like it's been in a bit of a fire. You guys could have saved whatever you wanted to. But you and you and you decided together to save the Queen of Diamonds. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
No.
I appreciate that very much. But this is America's Got Talent. I'm here to take this to the next level. And so, Howie, I don't know if you noticed, but there's an invisible deck of cards right next to your cup. Howie, if you would, I want you to just shuffle the deck for me, please. But you might want to take it out of the box first. Oh. Thank you.
Stupid me.
Great. And now feel free to show off all your shuffling skills. Just make sure it's really mixed. Oh my God.
Oh wow.
That was very impressive.
He's so good.
Howie's a pro.
Now, Howie, what I want you to do is just fan out the deck to yourself and pick out any card you want. Don't show me, but remember it. Make sure everyone can see it. Great. Howie, if there's an invisible Sharpie right next to your cup, sign the back of the card for me, just with your first name.
Okay.
Great, I don't want to see it. And now, take the card, slide it right back in, put that all back in the box, and then throw it right back up to me whenever you're ready. Perfect. Now, you, just minor miracles, it's fine. Howie, you shuffled the deck.
Yes.
You picked a card. You all saw it for the very first time. What's the card that you picked?
10 of clubs.
I want to clarify something. You and I have never met, correct?
Never.
Nobody came up to you before the show, said
no.
anything?
No.
For the very first time, I'm going to open this up. You said the 10 of clubs, correct?
I did.
Because every single card in here is face up, except for one. One card with a signature on it. Howie, can you confirm, is that your signature?
It is.
Will you flip that over for me?
Are you kidding me?
Is that your card? Thank you very much.
That's crazy.
Thank you, thank you.
And he kept all his clothes on.
Heidi, what do you think?
I mean, the audience was so quiet. I haven't heard this audience this quiet all day. I mean, we were all like, like hanging by every word that was coming out of your mouth, and it was incredible.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Really cool.
I'm like mesmerized. It was like fantastic, and it was funny at the beginning also with the invisible part.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Good job. Thank you.
I'm gonna make a prediction. No more advertising jobs for you. Because this is what I think you were born to do. Genuinely.
Thank you.
Yes!
Thank you so much.
I gotta say, and you know, people at home are always skeptical because they think, I swear to you, nobody here was in on this. This is my signature. That was incredible. I loved it, you know? I think it was really good, and I think you're really good.
I'm gonna start the voting with a yes.
It's a yes for me too.
Sophia?
Yes!
And Simon, 4 yeses!
Thank you. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you, Shira. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi. Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Thank you. Thank you.
Isn't it fun out here?
It's fun, man.
How is it when you're like in the wing, about to come out? Are you nervous then, or?
But Terry's back there.
What is he doing over there?
No, just, you know, giving motivational talks and everything. I think he has a TED Talk coming up or something. I don't know.
Okay, so tell us, who are you, how old are you, and where are you from, please?
My name is Orlando Leyva. I am 45, from Miami, Florida, and I'm a stand-up comic.
How did you get into that?
It's my wife. It was my birthday, and she gave me a gift to the school that teaches you improv acting. Mm-hmm. And then the improv teacher says, you're not good at improv. you should try stand-up.
And now you're here on the biggest stage in the world.
What a journey, man.
Take it away.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
I like his vibe.
Thank you, thank you. I'm happy to be here. My name is Orlando. I'm married, 15 years. You could hear it in my voice. There's a little essence of defeat every time I open my mouth. You hear it, like every good husband. Listen, woman, you want to get gelato after this? Is that possible? She's a good woman. She got me into that show, Yellowstone. I love that show. Yeah, it's a great show, but I feel like less of a man every time that I watch. Should I buy a truck? I feel like I should buy a truck. For those that don't know, Yellowstone is a TV show about a cattle ranch ran by the bodyguard himself, Kevin Costner. Yeah, a man, right? Mm-hmm. The writing is great, the acting is excellent, but the visuals of Yellowstone are amazing. Yellowstone, the park looks amazing. So imagine my excitement when my buddy Eric invited me to his wedding. Where? In Yellowstone. Are you coming? Oh, I'm there. I've been watching the show. The second I landed, guys, I got it. This place was so beautiful, so majestic. I understood Kevin Costner. Shoot, I became Kevin Costner. By the third day, I was telling people to get off my land. Get off my land! Sure, it was in the hotel courtyard, but that's the way that I felt. I couldn't stop saying, go on, get. You go on, get. You go on, get from that cucumber water, sir. You've had enough of our minerals. Thank you. I drove out into the park. I'm a city guy, man, and I was out there in nature, unsupervised. I saw elks, the real ones, with the coat racks. I saw elks. I saw bears doing bear stuff. They waved at me. One got a little bit too close. I said, you go on get, Yogi. I told him. Here's a big one. I saw bisons. Those are real. I thought bisons were made up like unicorns, but there he was, a bison in the middle of the road looking like a bougie cow, moo. I see you, bougie cow. I see you. I kept driving because they told me to go see Old Faithful. Old Faithful, for those that don't know, is a thermal geyser that shoots water and steam out into the sky from the middle of the earth. Allegedly, I hadn't seen it yet. When I got there, they call it Old Faithful because Old Faithful always goes off right on time, plus or minus 10 minutes. I read the sign, and Old Faithful did not let us down. It went off right on time, plus 10 minutes. It reminded me of me in my 20s. I was like, I remember when I could do that. Yeah, I can't do that anymore. I can't. I'm more like old dependable. Or maybe later, plus or minus 10 days. It all depends how my tummy feels. My name's Orlando Leyva. Thank you so much, guys.
Orlando!
Amazing balancing I've ever seen.
Unbelievable. Oh my goodness. I almost like a white this.
Thank you. you.
Thank you. Howie.
That is the scariest, most dangerous act I have ever seen on America's Got Talent.
There were no net.
Thank you.
I'm speechless, which is weird for me.
Good. I'll move on. Heidi.
This is how you do it!
Thank you!
I mean, you are daredevils. I'm sweating for my armpits so badly. I was screaming along. I love the two of you. You're amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Sophia.
That was spectacular. It was the most exciting, fun, scary. Even the moment that you looked like you were not gonna make it, made it even better.
Unbelievable. It was, from start to finish, about as close to perfection I've seen over the years.
You are absolutely brilliant.
Thank you.
That is very scary.
Okay.
We're gonna vote. Howie.
Yes.
Heidi.
A big fat yes!
Yes!
Sophia.
Yes!
I've done the numbers. It's about 4,000 yeses.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Who are you and where are you from?
My name is Maureen Langan. I live in Manhattan, but I grew up in Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey, where there is no lake.
So what is your talent? What will you be doing for us today?
I am a stand-up comedian.
What got you into comedy?
Well, I say a gift from God, but really, it's you grow up in a big Irish Catholic family with five siblings. You're always taking the crap out of each other, and it's just part of a natural wit, I think. You'll see.
Okay, the stage is yours. Have fun.
Thank you.
And hopefully we have some fun with you.
I don't want to hate people, they make me hate them. I'm all about love, you feel that immediately with me. But I was on the airplane coming here, a woman in the seat behind me, she gets up and she starts spritzing cinnamon. I go, lady, what are you doing? She goes, well, it's natural. I go, so's my butt, but I'm not putting it in your face. I didn't want to hate her. She made me hate her. Do you see what's happening there?
Yes.
I'm a victim. I had a car accident recently. I'm all right. Don't worry. Young guy, stoned out of his mind, on his cell phone, music blaring, looked a lot like you. Gets out of his car, you know, with the man bun. Dude, I don't know what happened, dude. I'm like, oh, what happened is in 1999, your mother forgot her birth control. That's what happened, dude. Well, wait a minute. I didn't want to say that. He made me say it. I was a victim. I was victimized. Okay, so but truth be told, I am at that age, post-period, pre-death. That's my age range. Here it is. I don't want to be a cougar. Absolutely not. I don't need some young hot guy named Chad touching my belly fat going, ooh, what's this? What's this? This is rage. Rage. Covered by affordable treats and wine from Trader Joe's. That's what this is. We got going here, baby.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. You know what I want? This is what I want. I want a guy around 86 years old, where I am the hottest thing between him and death. He can't believe he got me, because he knows he'll never get anyone better to the day he dies. And he's not looking over his shoulder for somebody younger and hotter. You know why? He has arthritis in his neck. He can't move his neck. And he sees none of my flaws. He sees no cellulite, belly fat, varicose veins. Why? Cataracts. Cataracts. And you know what? Let me tell you something. I love him. And I look into his milky white eyes. And I say, I love you! Because he's hard of hearing and I want him to know. Because I'm all about love. Thanks, you guys. I'm Maureen Langan. Thank you.
Jersey, 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 Jersey.
Thank you. That means a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
You're funny, Maureen. It's the timing. You just have this really good timing
in
your voice and how you just like bam, 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 bam. You just have the next one coming and the next one coming. I mean, I was laughing a lot. So were you. So were you.
Yeah, well, everybody was.
Were you laughing, Simon?
So funny, so fearless. That's what Simon says.
Thank you.
What about you, Sophia?
It was fascinating. Your energy, the way that you control the stage, you didn't miss one beat. You know your material.
She had like the body movement.
She was so cool.
Yeah.
You feel like you need to be like on a TV show, actually.
Thank you.
Yes. You know, you have a voice where we can hear you and we can hear your rhythm and we can hear your attitude and we love it and we connect with it. I think people not only are gonna love you, they will imitate you, they'll wanna see you. You have catchphrases.
Yes.
You have everything in that arsenal that a great comedian needs. You are ready to explode.
Thank you.
I wanted to love you and I did love you.
More women in comedy!
Let's vote. I'm gonna give you a first yes. You were fantastic.
Second yes.
Sophia!
I think people are gonna love you.
Thank you.
What do you think, Howie?
It's amazing, it's crazy, it's dangerous, it's wrong. You should change your name to Shish Kebab.
Heidi. Are you okay? Sophia.
I have mixed feelings. This is very disturbing and fun at the same time. It's like I like you and I don't like you at the same time.
I love that because we've seen this kind of app before, but the stuff I've seen before like this is tame in comparison, in my opinion. If anything, the app is too short. Okay, we're gonna vote. Howie, yes or no?
It's a yes for me. It's like crazy.
Heidi.
I want to say no, but I have to say yes.
Yeah.
I don't want to see you again, and I can't wait. Yes.
You've got four yeses. We'll see you again.
You.
We're great, but are you okay?
I'm hanging in there, literally, hanging.
Did something happen to you, or you?
I was playing basketball, and I tore my Achilles.
Right before coming to AGT.
Yeah, I had to. I didn't want to miss this opportunity to perform for you guys, so.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name is Barry Brewer.
Barry, where are you from?
I'm from the south side of Chicago.
Yeah.
Hey.
Well, the good thing is that you, whatever you're gonna do, looks like you're gonna do it sitting down, no?
Yes, I was gonna do stand-up comedy, but I'm gonna do sit-down today, so.
Oh. How did you realize that you had that gift?
I'm a musician, and I grew up playing in church on the weekends, and this guy said, man, you're funny. I was playing the drums for this community choir. He said, you should do some jokes for the concert. And I said, for real? And I did a church performance, and I got a standing ovation my first time, and I've been chasing that dream ever since.
Oh, wow. Good luck tonight.
Thank you so much.
Break a leg.
Thank you, Hal. I appreciate it.
I got
thank you,
you
so much.
I got you. There we go. All right.
Woo. Thank you so much. I did travel here from Chicago. And when I traveled, I thought that, you know, I would get a little empathy because I was on crutches because I like to go on vacation and forget I'm black sometimes. Some people don't understand. It's a little stressful. But when I got on the plane, this young lady clenched onto a purse. You know how you have to stand in first class and wait to get to coach? And she clenched onto her purse like I was gonna take it, and I was offended for two reasons. First reason is I can still take it. You're not that strong. You know what I mean? Like, you ain't been in the gym like that. Your little strength ain't gonna stop my yank if I was a thief. And then second reason, where I'm gonna go? I have crutches. You think I'm gonna steal your purse and go sit in 32C? I just think everybody should love everybody, right? Like, I just really believe in that. And being a musician, man, I got to play for different churches. I grew up and I learned how to play in church, so I got to play for black church and white church. Like, white church is a little more simple. Their Jesus is simple. The chords are simple. The pastor, he gets up, he does his message. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Thank you, God, that whosoever believeth in him, you just have to believe, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And church is over. That is church in white church. It's real simple to the point. Black church, I grew up, is different. You go to church on Sunday, and then when they preach, it's like serious, like, put your hands together for Jesus. He's been too good. Hey, yeah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that
that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hey!
I know white people be like, their Jesus is angry. Jesus is very angry. Their Jesus has been through a lot.
Good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you, beautiful girl?
I'm Mandy Muden. I'm from London in the United Kingdom.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
Oh.
It's been a rough couple of years, you know what I mean?
And what do you do, Mandy?
I do magic.
Why AGT? Now?
Well, being British, as Simon will back me up to say, I love America. Also, I owe money and had to get out of the UK.
What are you going to do with $1 million if you win?
Well, I do. I'd probably spend it on men.
On men? Okay, we're ready for you. We want to see your magic.
Okay, fantastic. Right, everybody, are you ready to get into a magic mood? Okay, America's Got Talent. Look at this. Four strangers ready to judge me. It's like one of those parties where you throw the car keys into the fishbowl. Heidi,
yes?
Would you just... I've got a bag here,
yes,
full of letters. Could you just reach in and get a few out just to make sure that they're all different? It's very difficult with the gloves on, isn't it? If you just committed a crime and hoping to get away with it.
They all look different.
Lovely. Shove that back. I'll give the bag a bit of a shake. Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I want you just to take a letter.
One?
Don't look at it.
Okay.
Okay, fantastic. Could you take one as well?
Take it out?
Yes, please. And don't look at it. We'll come back to that later. Okay, Sophia, could you do the same? Okay, fantastic. Now, Simon, I'm going to riffle through my book. Could you just stick anything in you like?
Finger?
Yes, a finger would be lovely, Simon. Okay, brilliant. Now, Simon, could you look at the page number?
Yes.
And the first word on the page, Simon.
Got it.
Okay, and could you write them down and remember them?
Yes, I can.
Okay, fantastic. I'm just going to pop back up to the stage. Feel free to check me out, Simon. Okay. Right, here we go. Now, Howie, I want you to think of any word at all in the English language.
Okay.
Now, would you be impressed if the word you were thinking of was written on a piece of paper in the bag in front of you?
Yes, more than impressed.
Please open the bag.
It's a dictionary.
Unbelievable. Heidi and Sophia, open your packages. Okay, Heidi, what lovely love story do you have, Heidi?
Mine says 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, now Simon, what page were you on?
70.
Okay, Heidi, could you turn to page 70? I'm just going to go into a trance and read your mind. Here we go. Page 70. Does your word begin with an F?
Yes.
Right, lovely. Now, are you familiar with this word?
Yes, I'm familiar with the word.
Okay. Now, the spirits are telling me that this word ends in I-N-G, okay? Have you done this word today?
Yes.
That's my girl, fantastic. Is your word by any chance, is it fantasizing?
Yes, it is.
Okay, now, Sophia, could you go to 17? Could you look at the last word on page 70, Sophia?
I don't have my glasses. 70.
Okay, Howie, you've got a dictionary there.
Yes.
Could you go to page 330?
Okay.
And could you go down 7 word entries?
7 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's
yes.
the word?
Loony.
No! It's loony!
Now, Simon, you were thinking of a word, you wrote it down. What was your word?
Eat.
Eat. Howie, you picked a letter.
Did you
hold your letter up and shout it out?
It's an E.
An E. E. What do you have there, Heidi?
I have an A.
And what do you have, Sophia?
A T.
Unbelievable. Thank you so much.
Bravo.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Mandy, that was quite a surprise.
Oh,
you're so funny, and I didn't expect to have so much fun. Howie?
You're a very good magician. You're funny. I love you. I'm a huge fan of yours. You are the epitome of somebody that deserves to have their own show. I would go see you in Las Vegas.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Heidi!
I think that you are adorable, and can I keep this?
Yes, of course.
Simon.
We saw everything, didn't we? I mean, you were mind reading, you were funny, you're very naughty. I really like you.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
So we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It's a yes from me for Mandy.
Oh, thank you so
Simon.
Much.
Simon.
It's a yes.
Howie.
Three yeses.
Oh.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Kevin Lee.
Hi, Kevin. Where are you from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Yeah!
Let's go! Yeah!
How old are you?
I'm 25.
What is your talent? What do you do?
I do magic.
We love magic.
Then you must be in the right place, because magic is magic on this show. Why AGT?
I grew up watching this show with my family, and it helped bond us, it helped connect us, and I hope I can share the same joy with other families watching.
Well, I wish you the best of luck. Go ahead, young man.
Thank you. It's thought that we each have a set of core memories that define who we are. Of course, photos help capture these memories. Judges, I have a few photos of us here. Simon, Heidi, Sophia, Howie, Terry, and myself to help take a mental snapshot of this moment right here. We share a lot of the same core memories, mostly from our childhood, like pulling your first all-nighter, your first crush. These images represent core memories we tend to all experience. Let's unlock some of them together now. Hi, Heidi.
Hello.
I'd like you to take out one of these pictures for me.
Yes.
They're all different. Don't look at it just yet.
Okay.
Heidi, I'm gonna close my eyes. Can you show the photo to everybody? Show the judges, show the world. And when you're done, Heidi, hide the photo, put it away. And everyone, just do your best to vividly remember all the details about it.
Yes.
Heidi, hold out your index finger for me. This is gonna help out a lot. Okay, go like this. ET phone home. I'm seeing a screen, not a small screen like a phone. This is larger. I'm smelling something buttery.
Whoa.
Judges, in the photo. Are you all eating popcorn at the movie theater?
No!
Sophia, can you pretend you're placing a piece of popcorn on my hand? Oh, that's a popcorn kernel. Watch closely. Don't blink. And popped. Simon, what do you see inside the box?
Nothing.
We'll take the kernel, place it inside, and heat it up a bit. Can you cup your hands for a minute?
Wow!
We tend to focus a lot on the future, that sometimes we forget about all the memories that made us who we are today. Let's rewind the hands of time even more. Judges, let's all go back. Look how cute you all are. Simon. These kids, especially me, would have never dreamed we'd all be here together. This memory we made here tonight will forever be a part of us, and I am just forever grateful. Thank you.
I love your magic. I love your magic. I love you. But I have to say, my favorite was when this kernel was coming out of your eyeball. I mean, it was like, it was kind of disgusting, but it was so cool. I loved it.
Thank you.
Sophia.
You know, it's amazing to see you now so emotional, because when you were doing your show, you were so in control. You looked like you were like, so present, everything. It was spectacular.
Thank you.
Simon, you're just good, and you're cool, and you're different. We've seen a lot of magic over the years, but you did something different. I could tell how much this means to you, which I think is amazing. And you're slick, and you're Vegas, and you're very us, and I really like you.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you.
You know, the story that you tell, the image of a little boy sitting in his home with his family and his parents watching America's Got Talent, and then years later, not only being on that spot that you watched, but rising to the occasion and rising above that occasion. I think you just had a career and life-changing performance.
Thank you.
Let's vote. It's a yes from me. Heidi.
It's a yes from me.
Sophia.
Yes.
You now have 4 yeses.
Let's go! Thank you.
But that thing with the
eye. The thing with the eye was so crazy.
It was so nasty. Yeah. I loved it.
Yeah.
Oh, Simon loves clowns.
Simon.
You love clowns?
He loves clowns.
Yeah. This is going to be fun. Good evening. How are you?
Hola, muy bien, gracias a usted.
Ah, habla español.
Sí, claro.
What is your name, nombre?
Me llamo Papayazo.
Papayazo.
Sí, Papayazo.
Where are you from? ¿De dónde eres?
De Chile.
Ah, from Chile. What are you going to do for us tonight, Papayazo?
Hoy día voy a hacer imitaciones.
Impressions. Sí. Okay, let's see what you've got tonight.
Okay. Primero, yo soy un elefante. ¿No? Ok. Quizás un perrito. Ruf, ruf.
No.
Is that
supposed to be a dog?
Okay, entonces, yo soy el Jason Statham. I got one last job for ya. And this time, it ain't gonna be easy.
That's perfect.
Okay, ustedes les quitan personas famosas, entonces aquí hay otra. Este es el David Attenborough.
The Chilean clown is known for surviving solely off laughter. Therefore, this clown is in mortal danger.
estoy bien, estoy bien, estoy bien. Ok, otra para ustedes. Este es el Jimmy Fallon. Got a great show night, everybody. We got Adam Driver in the house. Now, Adam Driver, I've been meaning to ask you, man, like, what's going on?
What's going on, Jimmy, is that I'm an incredibly gifted actor. And if you do not agree with that, then you do not know what I am capable of!
Whoa! Adam Driver, ¿no es cierto? Okay, okay, okay. Tengo una más para ustedes. Esta es la última, last one. Este es el Simon Cowell.
I don't mean to be rude, but I've seen funnier clowns in horror films.
Oh, yes! Muchas gracias!
Yes!
Amazing. I'm surprised. I thought you were gonna come and, you know, clown around. I'm gonna be honest, this was very big surprise. Good for you.
We look for moments and we look for surprises. And you are a moment and you are a surprise. The way you started out with the animal noises, we thought, oh, this is a joke act. And then you are one of the best impressionists I've ever heard.
I thought your impressions were amazing. What I even loved most is how excited you were when it worked out in the end. You did your impression and then you were so happy with yourself when you were laughing. That made me laugh.
seriously. I don't know what to say. I've never seen or met a funny clown in the world. You might be the only one.
Muchas gracias.
Bueno, vamos a votar. We're going to vote for
okay,
you.
Okay.
I'm going to give you the first yes.
Simon.
Two yeses.
Ali.
Second.
Four yeses.
What a beautiful dance. You must have the control over every little part of your body that you can make those swords dance around you like that. I mean, it was incredible.
Thanks.
Beautiful.
Thanks,
Sophia,
I cannot even imagine the amount of hours that you have put into this talent, because it seems like something very, very difficult. I thought it was spectacular.
Thank you.
Howie.
You know, when we asked you what you were gonna do, you said, I'm gonna do something beautiful and dangerous. And those two words describe it perfectly.
Yeah.
I can tell how emotional you got at the end, and this means a lot to you, right?
Yes, this is my life. This is a balance in my life.
Simon!
We've never seen anything like this before. I thought it was very dramatic, and it was very exciting.
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question? What is your dream?
Actually, I watched the AGT to learn how to perform.
Is that right?
My dream is very simple. Very simple. My dream is just stand here. Stand here is my dream. Wow.
Okay, Titos, we're gonna vote. I'm gonna start it off with your first yes.
Thank you.
Howie.
Second yes.
Thank you.
Sophia.
Three yeses.
Thank you.
Four yeses.
Noches.
What are your names?
Amalia.
My name is Yolexan.
We are Duo Daliva.
Where are you guys coming from?
De Cuba.
De Cuba.
De Cuba, bravo! Do you live in Cuba?
No, en estos momentos vivimos en Francia.
No, in these moments we are living in France.
Oh.
Pero nos gustaría mucho poder trabajar en Las Vegas.
But we would really like to work in Las Vegas.
Are you excited? Are you nervous that you're here?
Y llevamos tres años intentando llegar aquí y nuestro sueño se ha hecho realidad.
We've been working really hard to get here for the past 3 years and our dream was finally realized that we're here.
What are you guys going to do tonight?
Vamos a hacer equilibrio sobre rola bola.
We're going to do a balancing act on top of a rola bola.
Show us what you've got.
Thank you.
Buena suerte.
Sam Siri. My name is Sam Siri. I put music out as Nicotine Dolls.
Where are you from?
I live in New Jersey.
Tell me why you come on the show, Sam, please.
I came here because I've been making music my entire life, and like a month ago was the first month that I ever actually paid my bills or anything with making music, and that's really cool. And thank you.
Good. And did you have a normal job before you were making music?
Before this job, I cleaned houses and I painted houses.
Yep.
And I wasn't very good at the second one. I'm fantastic at cleaning houses. But the second one, if you're watching, I'm sorry that I did that to your house.
What's the big dream?
The dream is to be a musician, and that's my job, and that's what I do every day, and it self-sustains. Like, I'm gonna be creative, and that's gonna be my job, you know?
Okay. The good news is you're here.
I'm happy to be here. Thank you, guys.
And this is hopefully going to be your moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love the fact he's in a band, but it's only him. He's the star.
Stuffed inside that's tearing me up into the pieces on the floor, you see. I don't have an answer for you now. Stick around, I'll find a reason. Tell me what makes you shout. Tell me what makes you shout.
Amazing!
Your heart. If I was you, I'd fall apart next to this beating, bruising arm on a wall in a room no one wants to walk in. You leave me hanging and open. Oh, tell me what makes you sad. Tell me what makes you sad. You said, tell me.
I mean, if Rod Stewart and John Mayer had a baby...
Those are my parents.
It's like, what? I mean, special.
Thank you very much.
Very, very special, boys.
Thank you.
It was so different and sexy. And you know what? I think this is your moment, Sam.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You know what's great, Sam, is that it was really authentic. You were very honest with us as well. We got to know you really quickly, and it was like you swallowed a great singer. Because, you know, the way you talk, it's like there's somebody else in you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, I know how this is going to go, but we've got to do it. Heidi.
I mean, you're really special. Yes, 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 yes,
thank
yes,
you.
Yes, yes.
Sophia.
Yes.
You got three yeses, you're through to the next round. And who are you?
I am Kristen Cruz.
Hello, Kristen Cruz.
Nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you.
Nice,
and where are you from, Kristen?
I am from Crowley, Texas.
Okay. How old are you?
I'm 19 years old.
And who are you here with?
I'm here with my parents, my mom and my dad.
Yeah? Tell us about you.
So I sing.
Yes.
And I make drinks and videos of me singing.
At the same time?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, that's interesting.
I just really kind of just share
what
my
kind of
life.
Drinks?
Like matcha, coffee, protein shakes. And
yeah.
So.
Yeah!
Why have you decided to come from there to here now?
I tried getting a job at Home Depot, and I was like, you know what? I want to sing, you know? I don't want to not believe in myself and not try, you know?
What's the big dream?
To inspire people, to make them feel that you don't have to be anything else but yourself. I don't have to be the industry standard, you know?
I like that.
Well, I don't think the industry have got any idea what the standard is, if
yes.
I'm being honest with you. All right, Kristen. Best of luck. We're all rooting for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Butterfly. just forgive and forget. No, after catching you with her, your blood should run cold, so cold. Even though you're two-time and cheap lying wannabe, you're a fool. If you thought that I'd just let this go, I'll say red.
Singing.
Yeah.
You open your mouth and you're on fire.
I want your voice.
Me too.
I want it.
You're like,
I love everything about you. You are a star already in the making. I mean, you just have a real gift. You just have it. Thank you. Thank you so much.
The moment you started singing, you became so powerful, so confident. It was unexpected, and it was sexy.
Thank you.
I was surprised also because we have a lot of overconfident singers who come out here, and they're dreadful. And then you come out, and your voice, I mean, it is what I would call seasoned, you know? Yeah. You're not like, someone just starting. I mean, your range, your tone, you have great taste, by the way, because it was a great, great choice of song. You don't need smoothies when you sing, trust me.
Thank you.
We're gonna vote now. Let's start with Howie.
I like her a latte. Yes!
Definite yes for me.
Yes!
Thank you.
You've got four yeses.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. So good. So good.
That was great. That was lovely.
Wow. What is your name?
I'm Mike E. Winfield.
Mikey, what is your age?
Oh, so I'm like 20s to like 30s and stuff, you know, all right.
Where are you from?
I'm originally from Baltimore. I did adequate time in Sacramento, a lot of love.
What do you do?
You know what? I tell jokes, you know?
How long you been doing this?
Over 15 years.
So do you even remember the first time you step on a stage?
Oh my gosh, do I remember? Yeah, it was a Tuesday night open mic, and I get on stage with bright lights and arms crossed, and now they're all staring at me, and I just kind of freeze. So the fact that I came back, that means there's something wrong with me.
Okay, so show us what is wrong with you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, thank you. I love older moms. Like, I like it when her kids just moved out. I can set up my computer in the extra bedroom, you know? I got married to an older woman. I got a stepson. It's cool being a parent to a kid that's close to your age. I call him Stepman. He drove me here. That's my step homeboy, man. And it's a weird dynamic if you see it. He's like 6'2 with chest hair. I don't have any, you know? Teenage boys can be gross. You know when they're doing inappropriate stuff on their laptop, because when you walk in on them, they'll slam it down really fast and then ask you some irrelevant question. I walk in on Stepman. He's like, who's running for Congress? I'm like, oh. Oh, Stepman. I quit my job at the grocery store. Stepman's like, what are we gonna do for money, Step Mike? I'm like, hey, don't worry about it, okay? And I worked at this grocery store for a lot of hateful years. Why is it when you hate your job, they won't fire you? And now look, I worked in the worst department at the grocery store, not the meat, not produce, not the freezer. I worked in the steel department. You familiar with the steel department, right? Self-checkout lane? I got paid to watch people steal all day. And people think you stupid. Like, you know when they're gonna rob you when they're ringing up their stuff, they always gotta look back up at you. They're like, boop, boop. This one dude tried to humiliate me. Like, I knew he was gonna rob us because I'm looking at him. He's looking at me. I'm like, just steal it. But he tries to play me in front of the entire store while he's ringing his stuff up. He makes the beat noise with his mouth. He didn't even do it right. Like, you gotta act this out, go all in, raise your pitch at least. He's like, bleh. Like, the produce is not even supposed to make a sound. You're beeping unbeepable stuff. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Look at these people.
Oh, they're hearing it all. Look at this. Wow. Thank you so much.
I mean, I don't think there's anything else to say. They love you.
Oh,
I love you.
Thank you.
It's amazing. Your energy, your smile. I loved it.
Oh, thank you.
Howie.
Everything you say is memorable, is authentic. Your thank smile, you. Your persona. You're great. You're great.
Wow. Wow. I appreciate it.
Heidi.
You are fantastic. And then there's this face.
Thank you.
Look at his face. That face is just so cute.
Why don't you mention his face?
Isn't his face so cute? Yeah.
Stop it.
Well, you have a real star quality about you,
he
Mike.
He does.
You really do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
We could never do this show without an audience, particularly with an act like yourself, and this audience loved you. I mean, you could tell that.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you all. I appreciate you.
And Mike, look, we always say an audition on this show, 2 minutes literally can change your life. Maybe this is one of those auditions. I've got a good feeling about you.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to start voting. Simon.
Yes.
Me, yes.
Yes.
4 yeses.
Thank you.
Yeah, we love Mikey.
Very good.
Yeah, that kid's a star.
I mean,
yeah.
I think he's one of my favorite comedians that I've seen in these three seasons.
Hi.
Hi.
Who are you? Where are you from?
My name is Jack Williams.
Yes.
I am from Indianapolis, Indiana.
And I am guessing you are a magician.
Close. I am a ventriloquist.
Do you also know who is a very good ventriloquist?
Right there.
Exactly.
Fellow ventriloquist.
Yeah. We actually had 3 winners so far.
Exactly. It's honestly big shoes to fill. Terry was one of the first ventriloquists I ever saw. And when I saw him on the stage, I just thought, like, I just want to do that. That's amazing. That's why I wanted to come here today. I want to do this live, like, on the Vegas Strip.
Well, good luck to you. And
thank
we
you.
Can't wait to meet thank your friend.
Guys, give it up for my good buddy, Foster. Ready, buddy? Yeah, here we go. Woo. Hello. Here we are, buddy, AGT. My cloud is working. What's your plan?
Well, basically, I used you to smuggle me out here, and now I'm gonna show my talent.
He's funny.
Dude.
What's your talent?
Ventriloquism.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Really?
Yes. You think you're a better ventriloquist than me? You think you could talk without moving your lips?
Well, I don't have any, so yeah.
Okay. Let's see who's the better ventriloquist by doing some tongue twisters. I'll start by saying Sally sells seashells by the seashore, and then you go after. Okay, okay. Sally sells Sally, come on, okay. Sally,
it's like this. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Can you do that without moving your mouth?
No, no, I can't.
I love him.
I'm gonna do something I said I would never do.
You wouldn't.
I would.
Please. No.
I'm gonna throw your voice.
What? What?
Wow. I threw your voice, it's gone. It's gone, it's over there. Wait, 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 listen, listen, I think I hear it coming back.
What? I have your voice. And that means
I have your voice.
Wow!
Simon.
Yes.
Help me.
Here, come here, come here. Oh, that's better. Here, give it up for Foster, everybody. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, the judges are on their feet.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Who are you?
I'm Tyrone Lanner.
I'm Michael Lanner.
We are presenting a duel of a knife throwing.
No!
No.
Oh, we love those.
How do you know each other?
We are brothers.
They were roommates.
Yeah. So how dangerous is this act?
Very, very dangerous.
What is the craziest nightmare you've ever had?
Craziest nightmare already happened. It was hit each other with a knife.
Oh my God.
Where would you like to see yourself in a year?
Well, I hope to see in the biggest shows around the world.
Do you think you could do that?
I think yes.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh man, okay, they're bringing knives out. I'm gonna back up. good.
Oh my God.
I agree with you in every way. It was so cool, so dangerous. The speed that you're throwing things at each other while you're both moving are things beyond what we have seen before. Season 17 is just blowing my mind.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I was scared. It was frightening. I feel like you were a little scared too. I could see you were like so relieved every time he didn't hit you. And when it was over, you both were like, yes, we did it without hitting each other.
Simon, what do you think?
What you do, I can only imagine how scary it is.
If you want to try, I invite
yes.
you.
Go ahead,
for sure.
Simon, go.
Okay.
Really?
Okay, what do I do?
Okay, you just stand in the middle okay. without moving.
Okay. Have you watched the show before?
Yeah.
Do you like me?
Yes, yeah, of course.
Do you like me?
Yes, of course.
I guess it's safer than being on a bike.
Howie, shut up.
Okay. Oh, no.
Yes!
this means a lot to you. I can see that. I'm definitely saying yes.
I'm going to give you your four yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I can't believe it. Wow.
Welcome to America's Got Talent. What is your name?
My name is Mervant.
And where are you from, Mervant?
I'm from Philadelphia, PA. Philly in the house, baby. Philly in the house.
And what do you do?
I'm a magician.
You're a magician?
Oh. I'm a magician.
How old are you? How old are you?
I am 33 years old.
Do you make a living doing magic now?
I do my best.
What got you into magic?
You know, watching magic, it kind of made me feel like you have a real superpower, you know, like growing up. And I always loved comics and stuff, and that's the closest thing, right? Being a magician, so, yeah.
What does this mean to you? Y-A-G-T.
You know, if you can do it on this stage, you can do it anywhere.
Yeah.
I've been watching this on television for years, and to possibly have a Vegas show, to tour the world, it'd be a dream come true. Yeah. It really would.
And do you have any support? Does your family support this?
My family does. They've been absolutely wonderful. You know, this past year, I lost my grandmother. She was one of my biggest supporters in magic. I remember a couple years ago, I wanted to quit magic, and she said, "Don't you dare ever do that."
Aww.
And even at times when I wasn't performing a lot of shows, I always practice. And this is a testament to stick-to-itiveness, and I'm happy to be here.
Good for you. Good for you. The stage is yours.
Let's do it.
He is nervous as can be.
America's Got Talent. My name is Mervant, and I know you've seen a lot of magic on this show, but I want to show you something you've never seen with the deck of cards. I want you to watch each and every card closely, because I have a little story for you. And it goes like this. Two cards. Check it out. It goes one for the magic, two for illusion, three for the fact I can mix them both for the fusion, four for the suits of the playing cards that I'm using, so I'ma be the only one performer who would do this. Five-finger discounts led me to do some sleight of hand. I got a sixth sense for this. It's like I'm Spider-Man. Seven different wonders of the world. There's some great ones. Magic, music, illusion. I'm trying to be the eighth one. We make classes. It's the fly version of Di Vernon. Look close, I'm talking eyes burning. This is just another lesson. I'm lucky like number seven. Wouldn't believe this rap had five versions, but the sixth set may be the best yet. You know why? Because I wear a king suit. No tie, blindfolds on, my flourish is done with no eyes. Card disappear like in front of your nose. I got one heart for two arts, so I have to grind. Otherwise, I'd be sitting around feeling asinine. Jack of all trades, gold thoughts that I have to mine. Always trying to change my two tens, that's a paradigm. A paradigm's I probably go see ya. Paradigms like Heidi and Sophia. I'm a showman, so allow me to show you how I'm good with the jokes like Howie. Doing this for Simon so the world might hear me. Cruise to the top and get jacked like Terry. So, whether you were born a jack, a queen, or an ace, a raise as a diamond, joke a spade, or an eight, it's 7 billion people in the world and we're all connected. The different colors of the globe as the cards reflected. We're all from the same box when the cards collected. So if the deck is incomplete, then we're all affected. Be like the 7 to the Q and the 8-3 to be like playing cards and spread L-O-V-E.
Thank you.
Okay, and well, I'm guessing you guys are from Japan, from different places in Japan, I'm sure.
How do you work all that out?
What is your act going to be?
Today's act is going to be an original dance.
We're going to perform original dance performance.
They're going to do an original dance performance.
Okay, great. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
We were rivals. They're always the girls' group wins, or next time the boys' group win. So we've been rivals for many years.
So basically, they were competing together, and they were rivals, and now they've decided to basically perform together.
Exactly. You're so intelligent.
Who is better, you or you?
どっちが ベスト?
Oh.
まあ、どちらもベストです。
We're both the best.
I think we understood that.
Okay, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
I love the people that come here from Japan this year. It's brilliant.
See?
My name is Aiko, and I am from Japan. I live here now, and daytime I'm a translator, and I love my job because when I screw up, I'm the only person who knows about it.
So today you're coming to AGT to
yes.
do what?
I'm here to do a stand-up comedy.
You want to start already?
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Okay. My name is Aiko. In Japanese, it means love child. So I look up the dictionary. It says illegitimate child. My last name is Tanaka. It means in the rice field. So my whole name is illegitimate child in a rice field. Oh. Nice to meet you. I love rice.
Me too.
Is this a rice crowd? Yeah. I just got the citizenship.
Yeah!
Until I got my citizenship, I never had a road rage. If somebody cut me off, I'd be like, oh, so sorry. I was driving too slow. But the day I got the citizenship, somebody cut me off. I'm like, what the heck? You can't cut me off. This is my land. That's when I realized I become true American.
Oh, that's great. He's hilarious.
Because I felt entitled.
Oh!
Before the citizenship, somebody hold the door for me. I ran really fast. I'm like, thank you so much. After the citizenship, I'm like, you hold the door, you peasant. I got sassy.
I love her.
Racist people always say immigrants should not be working. I agree. We work too much.
That's a good point.
Now, whenever I feel lazy and I take a nap, I'm like, I'm doing this for America. Thank you, that's my time.
I was really enjoying it, and I think all of us were enjoying
Everybody
it.
Everybody was.
Thank you. Good job!
Why are you so emotional?
I struggle with insecurity, or a lot of people say I cannot do it because this is not my language, but then I had one person who really believed in me, which is my mom.
Your mom?
Last year during pandemic, she passed away.
Aww.
She wanted me to go for my dream.
I love it. How long have you been doing this?
For a few years. I perform everywhere. I perform in the prison. It's...
Well, it's important to have a captive audience, and
yes,
you
yeah,
found
yeah,
one.
Yeah.
I think your career is about to skyrocket, young lady. Mama was right.
From jail to America's Got Talent. I also thought you were hilarious.
Thank you.
But since you have your citizenship, don't get into trouble.
Don't get into trouble. That's going to be your bread and butter, I'm telling you.
But I had a lot of fun.
Simon, what did you think?
I mean, so funny, so naughty. From the minute you walked out, you got us. You know, and the best sign of a comedian's doing well, obviously, is the audience. And I really liked your reaction afterwards, because I could see how much this reaction meant to you as well. So I would like to give you your first yes.
Nice to meet you. Now, what are you going to be doing here on AGT?
I'm going to be doing stand-up comedy.
So when did you decide you were funny?
We'll see what the feedback is today. I was born deaf into a family that does not sign, and they're all hearing, so it's just me. So communication has always been something that I have struggled with. I think early on, I found that comedy is a language everyone understands. If I say something and you laugh at it, that's a connection. I always love that feeling.
Why AGT?
This is one of the biggest stages in the world, and watching some of the people that AGT has given opportunities to has given me more confidence to pursue this for myself. America's Got Talent, it's my mom's favorite show. We watch it together growing up, and it's surreal to be here. I'm like gonna cry thinking about that. To be auditioning for America's Got Talent, that has been the dream for me.
All right, Hayden. Who's the judge you wanna impress the most?
Honestly, I'm really hoping that Heidi likes my dress.
Oh, that's it.
I picked it specifically, so we'll see.
All right, go on out and make your dream come true right now.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Go right on up.
Hi. Good evening. How are you?
I'm totally kidding. Not about the sign language, that part is real. I'm working with an interpreter tonight. I am really hard of hearing. I perform my sets in English, but I do like to start that way because it does make heckling me an ADA violation.
Hello. What's your name?
How Hello, are Julie. You tonight?
Oh, I'm good. My name is Hayden Crystal. I'm a comedian. I'm actually a touring comic right now. But part of why I wanted to come to America's Got Talent is watching so many other comics with disabilities come here and succeed before I did, like Drew Lynch, DJ Demers years ago. Yeah. When I see other people with disability on this stage and thriving, I know that they were given the tools to be able to succeed here, which is... Not yet.
Thank you so much, then, for being here tonight. We're ready for you.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going to start. So I dual majored in college. I studied sign language, which that felt like a freebie, right? But I also majored in zookeeping. Which seemed like a really fun thing at the time, but now I have a degree in American Sign Language and zookeeping. And Coco the sign language gorilla died like 4 years ago. So what I'm saying is that comedy has to work out for me. Yeah, this has to go, guys, this has to go good. My safety net is dead, she's gone, so. I know, it's very sad. So I actually, I applied to work at the Coco Foundation when I was in college, and they rejected me because I have hearing loss. But they, yes, boo the Coco Foundation. They told me I was a liability issue because if the gorilla were to sneak up on me, I would not be able to hear it, which I can't say with any degree of certainty, but probably that seems true. So you guys seem like a nice crowd full of hearing people, so I'm just gonna toss this question out to the room. What are y'all gonna do different if a gorilla sneaks up on you?
It's true.
Yeah, thank you, I would love to know.
That makes a lot of sense.
DM me after the show. I'm just desperate to know what home field advantage y'all have with your 2 second head start. Ridiculous. Nothing. Nothing. The only thing you're going to do different than me is die scared. That's it. That's the only thing. Yeah. Thank you.
For being here tonight. I had a great time listening to you. I love that you make fun of yourself. I was laughing the whole time. Heidi, what do you think?
We have amazing comedians on the show, and I think that you would be a great addition to what we already have, so you can really battle it out with them.
Simon.
Was that a true story?
Yes.
I mean, it's brilliantly funny. So seriously, and the fact you could turn that into a funny story, which is so crazy that they would do that. To your point, what difference does it make?
You know,
I'm with you.
I've been trying to start Twitter beef with them for like 10 years. So if you guys
listen,
want to
I'll join
on
you.
That.
I can also see this means an awful lot to you.
Yeah, it's truly a privilege and an honor to just be here. Wow. So thank you.
I'm really happy that we met.
Thank you so much.
I think we're gonna vote now for you. Heidi, what is your vote?
I wanna see you more, so I'm gonna give you a first yes.
I'm gonna give you your second yes.
Hayden, I'm saying yes to you. And Julie, I'm also saying yes to you.
Welcome to America's Got
Thank
Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Mia Morris.
Hi, Mia Morris. And how old are you, Mia?
I'm 17, junior in high school.
Where are you from?
Nashville, Tennessee.
Obviously, you go to school.
I do, unfortunately, yes.
Unfortunately? You're not enjoying school?
School schmool, it is what it is.
I agree.
Could live without it, you know.
That's funny.
And what are you going to be doing for us tonight?
So I'm a songwriter. I'm going to be playing one of my songs, but I'm also a multi-instrumentalist. I'm playing as a one-woman band.
How do you play as a one-woman band? How do you play everything?
With this here loop pedal.
Oh, looping. Explain to the people what looping is.
So I like to describe a loop pedal as a recording studio at your feet.
Right.
I'll show you. Check. This is what a loop pedal does. This is what a loop pedal does. This is what a loop pedal does.
So you record each individual sound yourself, and then it plays on a loop, and hopefully it comes together and magic
and
happens.
And hopefully it comes together, yes.
I love that. Is this what you want to do for a living? Like, what's the dream?
My dream is to share my music and my writing with the world.
Wow.
Yeah.
I cannot wait to hear what you do.
Thank you.
I like this kind of thing.
I just want to start. I just think you're a star. I think looping is so cool.
Thank you.
The fact that you're playing every instrument, I could watch a concert. I could watch you doing this. I just love what you did. Heidi, what do you think?
I thought it was a lot of fun. One woman show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sophia?
I think you're one of the coolest girls that's been standing in that stage.
Simon?
I think, Mia, you know, look, it was at times a bit of a mess, but then again, it should be. You know, it's kind of like it's all done in the moment, so therefore it's not perfect, but it shouldn't be perfect, which is why I loved it so much.
Thank you.
I'd rather listen to somebody like you who's original and talented rather than someone who comes with some horrible backing track and sings a song I've heard a million times. This year, it's all about originality.
I can do that.
We're gonna vote really quickly. I'm giving you your first yes.
Thank you. I give you a second yes.
Thank you.
Sophia.
I love you, yes.
Three yeses.
Just genius, Mia. Absolutely genius. Four yeses. Yes.
Four yeses.
Thank you guys so much.
And I feel good. And it
crazy for you.
I paid them all to do that. So that was, I got you, Venmo. Okay.
What is your name?
My name is Jordan Connolly.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
And where do you come from?
I'm from Garden Grove, California.
And you came here to dance?
No,
to...
I actually came here to do stand-up comedy.
Jordan, how long have you been a comedian?
I've been doing it for 7 years now.
Okay, yeah. And that's how you make a living?
I would like to say yes, but also, do you want your fries with more ketchup? You know what I mean? Like, does
yeah,
that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, I just want to confirm. That's, so yeah.
But that didn't discourage you because here you are.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
So what is your dream? Where do you see yourself in the future?
I have very, very big dreams. So my dream right now is all based off of Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart did a football stadium. I think it was like 73,000 people. My goal is 73,001.
That's ambition.
Okay, so let's see what you've got.
Okay, thank you. So, I come from a very tough upbringing. Like, I have a military family. My parents met in the Marine Corps. Like, that's where my parents met, right? Like, my dad came to me, he was like, yo, it'd be so cool if my oldest son could join the military. I was like, Dad, it'll be so cool if you adopted somebody older than me. You know? I'm not that guy. I feel like if you're gonna go overseas, you need to be willing to take secrets to the grave. I'm not that guy, okay? You know what I mean? Like, if I go overseas, let's say I get captured, I become a prisoner of war. I'm telling my secrets, your secrets, and Victoria's secrets. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling them all. Like, I could be in a hostage situation and this guy's trying to threaten me. He's like, what's it gonna take to get the secrets from you? I'm like, sir, a pen and paper. Just. Listen, give me that. Put the knives away. This is a celebration. You caught the right guy, okay? The toughest person in my family is by far my mom. She's tough. She's old school. Like, if you ever got in trouble with her, she would turn whatever situation with you into a horror movie scene, I promise you. There's one day, she says, Jordan, didn't I tell you to come downstairs and do these dishes? You better do these dishes before you get in trouble. I lost in a video game. I got angry. I snapped. I said, you ain't done nothing all day. I suggest you stay downstairs and do them dishes before you get in trouble. Out of nowhere, this is all I heard.
Who the hell you think you're talking to?
As soon as I heard that voice, all the power in my house cut off, okay? The lights cut off, these crows came out of my closet, my windows opened up, there was these two little girls in a school uniform jumping rope and singing. They were like, one, two, your mama's coming for you. I woke up a week later confused. Thank you guys.
Something about your energy. I think you have all the future ahead of you.
Thank you so much.
You are just naturally funny because you are super, super talented.
Absolutely.
When you did The Voice, you really cracked me up. This was a really, really, really good audition. I like you a lot.
You are so fast. It's crazy how you go from here to there and here to there, but like I was like following. And then we're in your house and I was there with you and it was all funny. And I'm doing the same thing to my kids when they don't behave. Guess what?
You know, there are certain people. You mentioned Kevin Hart. And one of the things that makes these people stars is there are people that come out and then they do an act. And then there are people that come out, you believe there's no separation between who that person is and this is not an act. The difference is people go, I love Kevin Hart. People are gonna say, I love Jordan Connolly. It's not his act, I love him.
So we're gonna vote. I'm gonna give you your first yes.
1,000 yeses.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you? What's your name?
My name is Maxence.
Hi, Maxence. That's French.
Yes, I'm French from Paris.
Oh, wow. And how old are you?
32 years old.
And what do you do? What do you...
Magic.
Oh, magic.
Yay, we love magic.
How long have you been doing magic?
I'm starting when I was 10 years old. I saw a magician in cabaret make amazing trick with my hands. My brain is boom, and I say, I would like to be a magician, and I'm here.
This is the dream, right? To be here in America, to do well, and maybe win this thing, and then...
magic is my life.
Aww.
Well, go ahead, show us the magic.
Of course. Okay, today, America, I will show you three things. One prediction, one appearance, and a final impossible. But to begin, I need your credit card, please, Ari.
Credit card?
Sophia, could you sign this envelope for me? Do you have a marker?
Yeah.
It's okay. I have one.
Oh!
I have another one.
Okay, that's good.
Big sign on it, please.
A sign of what?
What you want.
A heart?
Yes, of course.
It's beautiful, huh?
Beautiful. Now it's unique envelope, yes?
Yes.
And your credit, please.
My credit card?
Yes.
Well,
thank you. I put it inside the envelope. It's okay for you?
Yes, it's okay for me.
And I close it. Oh, stupid. Simon, could you grab it with two fingers like that? Did you feel it inside? The card, of course.
Oui.
Thank you. Don't worry. In case of trouble with your credit card, I propose to you a compensation. A just-in-case box.
Oh.
But please, don't open it unless I ask you.
Okay, just in case.
Just
Let's
in case.
Start. Deck of cards, yes? This deck is a little bit special. We have 50 to drink on it, like, for example, coffee, red wine, beer, lemonade, tea. Of course, all the cards are different, blah, 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 okay? Mm-hmm. Touch any one card, but don't watch it for this moment.
Touch it, but
anyone.
Don't.
Perfect, take it.
Thank you.
My friend, let me introduce my mini theater. Behind the curtain, on the mini stage, I made a prediction. Suspense. Ladies and gentlemen, my prediction is a can of cola. I did for the first time. Tell me exactly what is your card.
It's not cola.
It's what?
It's milk.
Damn it. You know what? Let me show you the thing. No, it's better. Let me show you the thing. I have some paper. Number it from 1 to 7. Behind each number, we have something. You will choose any number between 1 and 7, and you'll try to make appear the object which is behind your selection. Tell me one number.
3.
Are you sure you can to change if you want?
No.
If you told me another number, we had different object, yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
But you told me number 3, and it's a mini helicopter.
Okay.
I try to make appear. I can do it. I hope so. By the way, ladies.
Yes.
This is for you.
Thank you.
Music maestro! You always have the card inside, yes?
Always had the card.
Let me introduce the magic machine. Listen to me. Actually, we would put the envelope inside the magic machine.
No.
And the credit card will be disappear.
No.
It's amazing trick. You can... What? Suspect 2, 3.
No, that's
yes.
real. It's real.
Give me 5, Simon.
Contrary, do you remember in case of trouble we have the just in case box?
Oh, yeah.
Open the box, watch inside, and show to everyone because.
Okay, you pull it down.
Yes, of course. Okay. Inside we have.
Scissors.
I never said it will be your card. Sizer is here for one reason. Since the beginning of the act, we have can of cola completely sealed, yes?
Yes.
Could you open the can for me, please?
Yes. Be careful with your nail.
You don't believe me, but inside it's not cola.
It's don't even.
Milk exactly like your choice. My prediction is true. Listen. Take it and shake.
What?
You hear inside? We have something inside. We need to cut the can because it's sealed. Feather, please.
I like the way you say that.
Yes, I do very slowly for you. Dramaturgy. Oh my God. Inside, we have something I don't want
watch
to touch anything but watch. Oh, inside the can.
That's your card?
Could you confirm? Yes.
It's got milk.
Exactly color. Your credit card.
That's my card.
That is impossible. Thank you, America.
Sophia.
I thought the whole thing was brilliant. You're so funny. The magic was also fantastic. I love how you interacted with us. I really love this act.
Okay, Heidi.
It was so much fun listening to you. I mean, you tick all the boxes. Funny, charming, you can do all the magic. Tick. I love what you just did.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're not only a great magician, you are very funny and you have this great energy. We didn't know where it was going, so it made it more surprising and fun. And can I have a cloth to wipe off my car?
Just use your pants.
No. Simon, what did you think?
At times, annoying.
No.
Unusual.
What?
Oh, yeah. However, the audience loved you. And the magic was très bien.
So let's vote. We're gonna vote. I'll start with Sophia.
Yes.
Heidi.
Yes.
Simon.
What? I think all things considered, yes.
I'm Henry from Brazil.
I'm Klaus. We are from Brazil.
Oh, both of you are from Brazil? How old are you guys?
I'm 30 and Klaus is 29.
Yeah.
Are you guys family, friends?
We are friends.
Yeah, we are friends and we are brother of soul,
So what is your act?
We are the first escape duo. We say brothers of soul because we really need to be like mentally and spiritually connected to each other.
Okay, and how long ago did you guys meet?
15 years ago.
Yeah.
We met each other in a performances club.
Why AGT? Has it been a dream of you guys?
Yeah, since we were a little kid, we dreamed to show our work to the entire world.
Okay, so we're happy that you guys are here. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We're just about to get inside these barrels and be lifted two stories in the air.
Oh, no.
Ooh, don't try this anywhere, especially at home.
This is rigged with some minor explosives. Don't worry, it's safe for you and for this beauty, but not for us. We'll be handcuffed to each other with only this hair clip to escape. And to make this even harder, this rope will be on fire. This gives us around 90 seconds to escape before that fire hits the barrels, causing them to explode. We fuzz inside. You follow this the entire time through these live cameras. One camera at Klaus' sides and the other camera at my side. Judges, wish us luck.
Good luck.
Being that cramped thing.
Why do people like doing these things? Oh no.
Uh-oh, here comes the fire.
Oh no.
Why does he want the camera so close to his face?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. All right, I've got the point. You want a close-up, then he's getting closer and closer.
You wanted to see your biggest reaction.
Well, you got it.
Yeah!
I loved it, too. I love the danger part of it. I love trying to figure it out, and I can't. And I loved the two of you. It was great.
Thank you.
Simon!
Hearts to like this. I think you've got great showmanship as well, the two. And I think that's really, really important. Anyway, we have to vote. Sophia.
Yes.
Thank you.
I'm going to say yes too.
And now you've got three yeses. What up? Nice to meet you, and what's your name?
My name is Mr. Pants.
Mr. Pants, I don't know how to say it, but your fly is open and something is poking out.
Is that your real name?
Yes.
What, Mr. Pants?
Mr. Pants, can we get a Q-tip for Simon over here? It's Mr. Pants.
Okay, Mr. Pants, tell me where you're from.
Brooklyn, New York.
What is your day job?
Well, I used to go to the office every day, but since the pandemic, I've been virtually replaced by sweatpants.
Okay. You're a comedian?
Sir, yes, sir. I'm here to dazzle you at my stand-up comedy routine.
So what's the dream, Mr. Pants?
Vegas, baby.
Okay, I'm not going to ask any more questions. Complete waste of time. Good luck.
Thank you. I'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pants!
Please, Terry, my father was Mr. Pants. Look, I'm gonna make this brief. I only got one day left on my return policy. I inherited my father's genes. He immigrated here from a banana republic. It was very hard on me growing up. He used to call me a huge waste. You see, both of my parents wanted me to become a lawyer. Never even came close to becoming a lawyer, but I was once involved in a suit. But I've since traveled the world. Went to Spain, fell madly in love with a Spanish sundress. And we broke up and I was pantalones.
Yeah! I love him.
But I'm happily married now.
Aw.
My wife and I are poly. It's polyester. Our daughter Capri brought home a pair of sweatpants. Hey, I want to be a supportive father, but I want to see her date someone ironed with a crease. This guy looked like he'd been donated. She asked if he could spend the night. I said, in my house, you'll sleep in separate drawers. Hey, guys, I'd love to tell you more jokes, but unfortunately, I left him in my other pants. Thank you so much. You've been a lovely crowd of people.
Buenas noches.
Ah, oh, buenas noches.
What is your name?
Conocido por Chico.
Chico.
Sorry, my English not good.
So I'm gonna help you.
Thank you very much.
Where do you come from?
Soy cubano, pero actualmente vivo en España.
He's from Cuba, but he lives in Spain right now. What are you going to show us tonight?
Vengo a presentarles un acto de
equilibrio. He's gonna do a very dangerous balancing act.
Oh.
We're ready for you. Bueno, chico, adelante.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Those are knives.
Have you been doing this act for?
Es la segunda vez que lo hago en mi vida.
What? What? Second time he does it in his life.
What?
No.
Wow. That was really scary.
Que da mucho miedo.
Amazing.
Fantástico.
The knives. There's no.
Los cuchillos.
The cuchillos. I love it.
It leaves me wanting more. I want to see what else you're
going to
do.
Más.
She wants to see her pachitos.
Chico, what is his name?
Michael.
Michael.
Y estoy acá con mi hermano, que es mi compañero de 25 años de trabajo.
He's his brother, who is his partner, his friend.
We love you, both of you. I want to say your cuchillos are fantastical.
Thank you.
Let's vote.
Sí.
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 Super sí.
A super, super sí.
Cuatro sí.
Thank you very much.
Do you have to use the bathroom?
No, I already did. I took this out of the bathroom.
Oh, okay. Who are you?
My name is Adam Winrich. I'm 40 years old from Fall Creek, Wisconsin.
And what is your act, Adam?
My act is mainly whip cracking.
So do you make a living by whipping? Wiping? What?
We got it covered. I make a living traveling around the country, and we do Renaissance festivals.
What is the plan with this? Where do you want to go with your wiping?
My hope is to do it for as long as I can do it, hopefully into my 60s, maybe even to my 70s.
Okay, perfect. Then we're ready for you.
And one other thing I was going to say before I get going, I will need a volunteer. I want to say that first.
Sophia, but... Sophia, 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 Sophia,
Sophia, Sophia.
Stand right there, please. Sophia, have you ever had a whip cracked around you before?
I'm not gonna say that to you.
That means yes.
Not on a stage.
Not a
like AGT.
Fair enough. Okay, here we go.
No, wait. Do I have to close my eyes or something?
If you want to.
You'll be fine. Just don't move.
Are you ready?
No.
Here we go. Actually, you do. That was a great setup. Thank you, Heidi. Hold on to that right there. And I'm just going to do a big arm swing.
ever thought about that.
All right, let's do a big arm swing all the way around your head.
I know, I can feel it.
I don't like this. Yeah, that was better. That was so good.
I want to go home.
We made a little bit of a mess, Sophia. Do y'all want to see a big mess? Of course they do.
Please.
Oh, no.
What's he going to do with that?
Sophia, if you would come over here, please. This is the funnest part.
Huh?
You get to shoot me with a toilet paper cannon. Put it on your hip. When I say go, you just roll that button all the way forward.
And then what?
You'll see.
Hey, ah!
Sophia, you ready? And go!
Go, Sophia!
So much.
Hey everyone, it's great to be here. Simon.
Yes.
When you were a kid in the 1870s, did you have flashcards?
Aiden.
They used to help me read, and now they even help me read minds. I know, spooky. So here they are, the 26 letters of the alphabet,
yep.
All with their own individual image. So, can you tell me when to stop, please? Whenever you want.
Okay. Stop!
Oh, are you sure?
Yep.
All right, great. So take this card, don't look at it, and we'll get back to it in a second.
Thank you, Aiden.
Thank you. Heidi.
Yes?
I want you to look into my eyes. Ooh. Now, I do this to create a strong connection with the person. But in your case, I just wanted to look into your eyes. Heidi, you gave me the gift of the golden buzzer.
Yes.
So I brought you a gift,
oh.
But you can't open it yet.
Okay.
We'll leave it right there.
Thank you.
Because in only one of those balloons, I have a prediction, a card that hopefully matches your card. And if you get it right, you can open your gift. And I'll need someone to help me on stage. Someone charming, charismatic, handsome, funny,
yes.
Known all around the world. So where are you, Terry? Come on out. Terry, as always, you're looking nearly as buff as me. Keep going to the gym, hang in there. You'll get these bad boys soon enough.
He's so funny.
Terry, I want you to hold on to these darts for me. So Simon, you'll go first. Pick a balloon you don't think that my prediction's in.
Pink.
Pink, all right. Terry, throw the dart at the pink balloon.
All right.
Let's see. And... you were right, Terry, no card. Howie, it's your turn now. I know, tough choice, they all look a lot like you, but try to pick a balloon. Pick a balloon you don't think my prediction is in.
Yellow.
Terry, pop the yellow balloon. You were right, no card. Heidi.
Yes.
No pressure. If you do this wrong, my trick is ruined and it will be a long flight back to Ireland. So, green or blue balloon, which one do you want Terry to pop?
Blue.
Terry, pop the blue balloon. Let's see. And you were all right. No card, which must mean my prediction's in this balloon. All right, here we go. Terry, can you hear this?
I can hear it.
That's my prediction. Pop the balloon. Look it, a card came out. Terry, show everyone what that card is.
It is...
an octopus. Simon, for the first time, show everyone what card you chose.
Yes!
It's an octopus. Thank you so much, Terry. You've been great.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Heidi.
I can open it?
Well, since you got it right, you can open it. What's in there?
An octopus.
A purple octopus! Now, to prove that I knew it was octopus from the very beginning, everybody, look up! Everyone get a balloon! Judges, get a balloon! Everyone, hold up what's inside! Everyone get a balloon, hold up what's inside!
Oh my gosh!
Skilled as a grown magician. You really are, but it's just much cuter when you do it. It really is. We're gonna get this all the way. Why not? Let's win this thing! That was so good!
Simon!
Yeah, I just think you need a bit more confidence. No, that was actually quite amazing. You've got an amazing personality. I mean, honestly, incredible. Everyone tonight has been fantastic.
I agree.
Thank you.
Howie.
Yeah, I agree with what my fellow judges said. The magic was impeccable. And you have such a stage presence. You're a great comedian, you're a great performer, and you're a great magician. And most of all, you're an all-star.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Aiden. Aiden has done all he can. It's now up to the super fans to decide if he should be our All-Stars champion. We'll get the result in next week's finale. For now, make some noise for Aiden McCann.
Thanks for my presence.
Thank you. Bye, guys. Thank you.
He's just adorable.
It's one thing to remember the magic, but how does he remember all those jokes? And when things happen, he thinks on his feet.
Away from South Africa. Tell me, how does it feel to be on All Stars?
Yeah, we're so excited to be here. Like, we just wanted this chance, and now we got it, and we are back.
Hi, we are the Ndlovu Youth Choir. We are from South Africa in Limpopo. Before the audition, life was really hard. We were collecting water using wheelbarrows, you know, when we went to fetch water.
We started this choir to give young people on the African continent a voice they didn't have.
Some of us have been able to support our families and, you know, getting electricity. We now have running water.
Well, coming into this competition, we have a whole lot of weight on our shoulders, more so because we're representing Africa as a whole.
We got this opportunity that a lot of guys like us back home are wishing and hoping for.
I say the message we always try to transcend is that you can overcome your obstacles, your problems. It should never define you. It should never.
We were excited to be here on AGT All Stars. We want to show the whole world that anything is possible.
Welcome back. Can you introduce yourselves again, please?
We are the Ndlovu Youth Choir, all the way from South Africa, Limpopo.
You did amazing on the show. We've used you as a reference for some of the best choirs we've ever had.
Thank you, thank you.
For me, this is my favorite choir that has ever been on AGT.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You feeling confident?
Definitely, we're here to win this.
Yeah! Yes!
I would think it must be the hardest thing being in a choir is how do you choose the song?
So we've been brave and we've chosen an original song.
That's good.
And I think it shows the progression because we want to be creative and we want to create our own music.
And the song is about?
It's about the resilience of the human spirit. It says we will rise.
I like that.
Yeah!
Okay. Good luck.
was my first time with you guys, and I loved it. I love how vibrant you are inside and out. I loved it.
Traditionally, I don't respond to choirs. I've seen choirs, and I always kind of have the same comment. The same comment is, I feel like it's a school assembly, and it's nice for that. This didn't look like an assembly. This looked like a finished Broadway show. And I truly mean this. For me, this would have been a golden buzzer moment, really. Wow. It would have been.
Well, first of all, absolutely, you did the right thing coming back with your own material. I thought it was just strong. I got it. I think Howie's reference as a Broadway show is absolutely on the money. And what an unbelievable reaction from the audience behind me.
Yes, yes.
Really? Because that you can't take.
Hopefully they get that same reaction from the super fans, because the super fans can only pick one act from the night.
I know, literally one. However, you did everything you possibly could, in my opinion, and I can't be more thrilled that you've come back to compete again. All of you, thank you.
You are fantastic! Fantastic!
All right, there you go, guys. What do you want to say to the super fans?
We just want to say to the super fans that we're just so happy to be here, and you have the opportunity to give us one more shot, and we'd really appreciate it.
Let's do this.
All right. Heidi.
Yes.
Please come join me on stage.
On stage. Again.
Have a seat here. Hello. Wow, you're much taller than I thought you were.
Good to see you. Yeah. I'm excited. I get to see this right here.
Okay, here we go.
Let me start by saying this. I love my wife. I love my family. I got a super old stepson. You know, it's weird because my buddies, close friends, they won't date women with kids, which is strange to me because it changed my life. I never thought like I had such a deep love for this child. Support, check. Every other Thursday, me and Stepman wait outside by the mailbox. I got this new move I do for the mail lady when she shows up. I'm like, thank you. Because that's how Stepman and I bond. We buy stuff with the child support check. It's not a lot of money, but we get to hang out, you know? My close friends, they don't even know. They just know the stuff. They're like, dude, where you get that jacket? I'm like, my baby daddy. You need to get you one, playboy. I'm just trying to find my parenting flow, you know? Because my parents, they had unique approaches. I remember when I started stand-up, my mom, she just quit her job, zero savings. She said, Jesus is gonna pay her bills. And several years later, she had zero debt. She made me a believer because that's when I found out that I was Jesus. Trying to find my parenting flow. So me and Stepman, we hang out. We went to an appliance store. We're leaving, we're in a parking lot. Some lady, she runs out to me. She's like, sir, you forgot this. I'm like, thank you, ma'am. It wasn't mine. I just got nervous. I thought she was coming to tell me my transaction didn't go through. But instead, I got hooked up with some Hoover vacuum cleaner bags, right? But then I'm like, what am I doing? I don't steal. I'm supposed to be a role model for Stepman here. Let me handle this. I'm gonna handle this. Stepman's like, I'll handle it. I'm like, okay. And he handled it. Stepman handled it. He went back inside of the store and stole a vacuum cleaner. And there's my parenting flow. I'm Mikey Winfield. Good night. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Mikey Winfield.
Thank you. Looking so good. Simon, your golden buzzer.
Mike, you were so funny when we saw you earlier on, and there was only one thing you had to do tonight, be funnier, and you were. I mean, brilliant.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
I think you've given yourself a shot after that. And I know we say this a lot, and all these shows say this, oh yeah, you're a star. You are a star.
Thank you, Simon.
Howie!
Oh, I agree with everything you're saying. And wouldn't that be great? We've never had a comedian win even AGT, let alone AGT All-Stars. I hope it. I wish it. We now know him and we love him and we're waiting for the next story about Stepman, which should end up being a show with Terry Crews.
Yeah, I'll be Stepman.
Being your Stepman. That's a great series right there. It's amazing.
Heidi!
Yeah. I mean, you are just a true entertainer in the best possible way. I mean, you just have it all. You have the full package, and that smile does win me over every time. And so do your jokes, by the way.
Thank you, Heidi. Thank you. I appreciate it. Now, Mike, you always said you wanted to be the first comedian to win AGT. How's that working for you right now? You know what? This is the thing. I was devastated when I left and I lost, you know? And then when I got the call, I felt like I had a second chance. And I feel like now is that second chance. And I'm riding the wave of Simon's golden buzzer, and I just feel like I have a shot. Right now, I have a chance.
I believe you, Mike.
Thank you.
Good luck tonight, Mike. So, will Mike be the first comedian to win an AGT competition? We will find out what the superfans decide in the finale. Give it up for Mike E. Winfield!
Thank you very much.
Wow, thank you.
That is a good show with him and Terry playing stepman.
I want to be the stepmom.
Ladies and gentlemen, need the assistance of one of the judges, Heidi.
Really?
Please join me on stage.
Yes,
yes, really. Heidi Klum, everybody. Give her a round of applause.
Hi.
Heidi.
Hi.
Thank you for joining me.
I'm so excited.
You and I are going to do something really amazing together. But first, I need you to blow that up. That's an animal balloon.
Okay.
Go ahead. Give it. Take your time. Okay.
That was a joke.
Oh, that was for her.
Okay, you can take it away.
Take it away. I'll do it myself. Hi, Sadie, you and I are gonna do something incredible. I am going to make an animal balloon on stage in a way that no one else has ever done in the world. Oh, get this, I'm gonna do it psychically. Don't patronize me. Hey, Terry, can you just come out here for a second?
You
Terry,
got it, you got it. Hey.
Terry, I need you to think of an animal. You got
okay.
it? Lock it in your head, okay? Don't say it out loud.
I got it.
Okay, here we go. Heidi?
Yes.
Let's do this. I need some help. Everybody, go! Go! Go!
Go! Go! Go! Go!
A giant magic marker right here. So, giant, just go with it. I have a giant marker. It popped. Ta-da! Heidi, have a seat. Give her a hand, folks. Heidi Klum, everybody.
How was that?
She did the best she could. That was for her.
That was for you.
Okay, all right. Out of curiosity, what animal were you thinking of?
Aardvark.
Aardvark?
Yeah.
Aardvark. No. If you look on the balloon,
it does says Aardvark.
It says Aardvark. I missed you.
I know. I mean, I've really missed you. I mean, you are hilarious.
Thank you.
You're incredible. And you make me laugh.
Thank you.
What did you think, Simon?
It was like being at a very weird children's party.
Thank you.
I don't know. It just took a long time to get there, I think. And the end wasn't very impressive. I mean, look, Brett, I like you. However, this is called All Stars, and we do expect people to come back and hopefully wow us. And you didn't.
Heidi and I don't think we agree with you.
No, we don't.
I don't think we agree with you. You know what? You're funny, you're a crowd pleaser, you're a great magician. It's a combination of amazing and disgusting, all in one.
I love it.
The good thing is, it is not up to us, it's up to the super fans, so.
Thank you, everybody, thank you.
Aardvark? You said think of an animal. I guess, you know what? It went alphabetical, okay?
All right.
The reason that I'm a psychic today is because of my aunt. She used to host these tea parties where she'd read tea leaves, psychically divining questions and concerns from members of the public. And I'd like to show you what one of those is like tonight. But I'll obviously need some guests. So Terry Crews, who would come out and join me? Terry Crews, everyone, give him a round of applause. Hello, Terry. I want you to pick a member of our audience to join us during this. So look at our beautiful audience, and then...
How about you, the young lady right there? Yes, yes.
Join us on stage. Give her a lovely round of applause. Up you come. And then, Terry, if you want to go and sit on that far seat for me, Howie Mandel, will you join me on stage
You're
as well?
Get
Everyone,
into
give
my
Howie
mind.
A big round of applause. Up you come, Howie. You want to sit just down there. So when people come to psychic tea parties like this, they tend to ask a question they don't know the answer to. And Howie, that's exactly the sort of question I'd like you to think of right now. I'm gonna look away. I want you to write that question nice and clearly on that piece of paper so you can show the other judges. And just let me know as soon as you're finished with that.
I've got it.
You got it?
I do.
Perfect. Will you show the other judges? I'll keep looking, Wayne. And then as soon as you've done that, I want you to take that piece of paper, tear it up and throw it in the teapot in front of you.
It's a lot of work.
So your question's gonna brew with the tea now.
Okay.
Which basically means that I can drink your question and figure out what it is. Okay, so straight away, you're normally like a comedic person. And I get the vibe that this is about your family, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Alex, isn't it? You're thinking of Alex, your son.
Yes.
Yes. And this is something you tease him about a lot because you want to know whether he's going to find someone to marry, don't you?
Well, yes.
Whoa.
I saw that.
Now, the second question that people ask psychics is questions that they know the answer to, and they're looking for me to prove my psychic skills. That's why I asked Terry to bring you on stage, someone that none of us has ever met before. Your name is?
Grace.
Grace, lovely to meet you, Grace. Now, Grace, I want you to get a question in mind that if I knew the answer to, would convince you that I was psychic.
Okay.
So, have you got something in mind?
Yes.
Yes, perfect. Okay, I want you to put your left index finger in your tea for me. And I just want you to think about that question, okay? So, right.
I'm thinking.
Okay, right, you can take your finger out. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I will try this.
Oh.
Grace, you've already decided what your child's name should be, haven't you?
Yes.
Yes, good, okay. Look forward for me, and in a second, out loud for everyone, say the name that you want to name your child. Keep your eyes forward, no peeking. Out loud for everyone. What do you want to name your child?
Summer.
Oh,
Summer.
No.
Now, Terry.
Yeah.
So I want you to get your question in mind now.
Okay.
And then I want you to pick up your cup of tea and just hold it in between two hands. I'm going to reach around you so I can hold your hands. This is for the psychic demonstration. Also. We'll keep going. Okay. Okay, Simon, Terry's slightly harder to read, and I don't want to get this wrong because we. Okay, we'll try this. My aunt always said when you're not sure of something in life, you'll find the answer at the bottom of a cup of tea. Terry, what was your question?
What size are my shoes?
What size are your shoes?
One of a kind.
One of a kind. And for everyone here, what size are your shoes?
14.
14.
Oh, no! It's in size 14.
Kidding me?
Wow.
Wow. Thank you so much, Terry, Grace, Howie. Good night.
I have a lot to say, but before I say anything, why? I think you are 100% wrong, Simon.
I tell you what, because it's not always about the finish, it's getting there. And how you got there wasn't very good, in my opinion, because it takes too long. And I think it's your lack of showmanship.
Really?
Yeah, I really, really do.
I disagree. I think you have great showmanship.
Thank you so much.
I'm telling you, it is so exciting to have somebody read your mind. What he did is like a superpower.
Agree. I was there. I saw it.
If I have to say anything negative, it's the fact that the superfans only have one choice from each evening to go through to the finals. If it was up to me, that was an act that I think is worthy, you don't agree with me, but is worthy of the final. And I can't wait to see what you would do next.
I love you, and I'm so happy that you're back.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, guys.
Bye, good luck to you.
What is up with Simon, man?
I think he's impatient. He's got a short attention span. He wants it straight away. And you know, psychic powers takes time. He always he always says that he believes in magic, but magic isn't instant.
I'm telling you,
but it's such a good mixture.
No, really? I don't think so.
I think really Simon's scared about what I know about him. Ah. So maybe if you see me in the final, I'll reveal something.
Now tonight, I'm gonna try and prove to you all that time travel really does exist, which I know is a crazy thing. And Heidi, please can you come and join me up on stage and make sure you've got your cell phone with you too. Round of applause for Heidi. Come on guys, keep it going. Heidi, you can take a seat. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I've got a deck of cards here.
Okay.
And I need a favor from you. I want you to tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Right there?
Yep.
Okay. I want you to take that card.
Yep.
Show it round, and it doesn't matter if I see this card as well, because this is not a card trick. The five of spades. Make sure it's face up. Place it somewhere around the middle. There we go. Okay. Now, everyone, I want you to remember this moment right here, where all the cards were face down, apart from one, and that is your card, the five of spades.
Yes.
Now we'll do this again. I'm gonna take about half the cards face up and half the cards face down, and I'm gonna mix them together. There's a technical term for this, Heidi. It's called a mess.
A mess.
Now, Heidi, I want you to take the five of spades
yeah.
and turn it face down,
mm-hmm.
and then place it once again somewhere around the middle. Okay. Now, you've got your phone there, and I'm gonna take a picture of you. Is that okay?
Sure.
Perfect. I also want you to hold onto these cards. Okay, maybe use both hands. Make sure you don't drop them.
Nope.
Okay. And I want you to give me your best model face. So here we go. Perfect. I'll take the cards from you. All right. Audience, are you ready to prove that time travel really does exist? Okay, here we go then. And we're gonna use my phone for this. So here we go. I want you to watch closely as you will see the time start ticking back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Heidi, we've just gone back in time. 5 minutes. I want you to look at your phone and show me the time on your phone as well.
Yeah, 6:45.
We've both gone back in time. 5 minutes. But that's not it. Audience, I want you to take your phones out right now. You have all just gone back in time. 5 minutes. If we really have gone back in time,
yeah.
then this deck of cards that was a mess should now have returned to the point that I asked you all to remember when they were all face down apart from the five of spades.
Yes, there it is.
There it is. Now, Heidi,
yes.
a few minutes ago we took a picture on your phone.
Yes.
So because we went back in time 5 minutes and the deck of cards has changed, that picture has also changed. So I want you to go to that picture.
Mm-hmm.
You can see that Heidi, you are in fact holding a deck of cards that is all facing one way.
Yes.
Apart from your card, the five of spades. But Heidi, if I really could time travel, then why not go back more than 5 minutes? Why not go back before I even left my home in England? Then I'd know what your card was, the five of spades.
Yes.
And I did. And if you don't believe me, watch this. I'm leaving home right now to come to you guys in America. I am super excited to come and see you. It's currently 5 a.m. I'm just looking for the gate now. So, there it is. I'm on the plane now, and I'm about to take my seat. I'm finally here at the airport in LA. I'm gonna go to the hotel, and I'll see you very soon.
You went back.
Heidi, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amazing. Wow.
Brandon Leak, season 15, Howie's Golden Buzzer, but you went on to win the whole thing.
I imagined a very different life, growing up in Stockton, California, in poverty, loss of my sister, fatherless childhood. Writing poetry became my big outlet.
All the things I wish we could have done, I played again and again and again, and I'm tired of playing God because I got to come to terms with the fact that my sister ain't never coming back.
You know, the world shut down that day. They almost canceled the entire show.
We feel your pain, we feel your love, and you moved me to do this.
I still, to this day, don't think I've proven the point. A slew of people were like, oh, he only won because there wasn't an audience. This doesn't translate to a large stage. I looked at it as, all right, Brandon, you got more work to do.
Are you excited for the
game? I'm immensely excited to finally give a live audience a good taste of what I do in person.
Okay, here we go.
See, brother. My man, Brandon Lee!
So yeah, I prepared to win. I'll show you that today.
This is my golden buzzer.
How does that feel, Brandon? All your performances were without an audience. Yeah.
Y'all tell me, how's it feel, baby? It feels about that good.
Yeah, and you are that good. How old are you now?
I'm a big 3-0 now, and I got two beautiful kids.
Yeah!
So, yeah.
Did your life change after AGT?
Oh, without question, you know, just my opportunities. You know, leaving a stage like this, the America's largest stage, it provides doors that I never had before. You know, what I've been doing recently is helping the 12 schools in my city. And we're publishing 6,000 kids this year.
That's amazing. And what is the dream? Like, why even come back?
Oh man, well, my biggest dream is to help elevate spoken word to a point where the people see it just as normally as every other art form.
You know what? I feel like on that same year that you won, I think that young girl who performed at the inauguration.
Amanda Gorman.
Yes. I think that you opened the door for 100%. Moments like that. And I cannot wait to see what you have in store next.
Thank you. While on a walk, I saw a transient man standing on the corner. And immediately, I reached into my pocket. Not so I could grab money or anything like that, but so I could get my phone, you know, so I could fake text or pretend like I was listening to music, because I figured my persistence to keep my distance would make it hurt less when I ignored his existence. It, at least for me, anyway. But then suddenly, a very peculiar smell emanating from the man invaded my nostrils. It reminded me of all the things that our culture deems worthy of throwing away. And the irony is, that's the same way that we would treat him. But then inside my soul, something said, Brandon, put your pride aside and go talk to that man, so I did. I asked if he could share with me a bit of his story. All he could do was say, glory, hallelujah, of course I can. He told me of a man who had everything. The people bowed down at his feet, and they allowed their praises to raise his stature to nothing less than God reincarnated in human flesh. Where I'm from, that's the Pharaoh complex, I'm pretty sure, but you see, the issue with towering above all has never been that climb up, but that cataclysmic fall back down to humility in which most don't survive. And I imagine him losing everything. And he told me, young man, don't be foolish. The reality is that I woke up and realized that your life only works when your life's work is worth your life. And I realized my life's work was worthless. Worthless, and this broke me. It broke me to see my reflection splintered, broken, barren. So I grabbed everything I could fit into these bare hands, and I ran till I couldn't run no more. It all seemed so real to him. You could see it ruminating in his eyes again and again. And he stopped my train of thought saying, young man, do you know why I smell like this? He said, I smell like this to remind myself that self-sufficiency will no longer keep me clean, because do you know why you wear those clothes? Is it simply to look appealing or to hide the fact that you're healing? Never in a million years did I think I'd take hygiene tips from a guy like this. But I did. And the craziest part is, as all these cars drove by, I wonder which one of us they thought was clean. So I guess the moral of the story is, you can never judge a book by its cover.
Wow.
never forget. I mean, I remember watching that final, and I never forget when. Who's that?
My daughter's over there.
Say hi, Dada.
Oh, hello.
Hi, Dada.
Can she come up?
Of course.
Yeah.
Come on, Boo-Boo. Here, Boo-Boo.
She's so cute.
Brandon, what's her name?
Her name is Aaliyah.
Aaliyah. Hello. She's taking away the limelight from you, Brandon.
Every day of my life.
She's so cute. No, I was going to say, I remember that night. You know, I never in my wildest dreams would have thought someone with an act like yours could win AGT, but you won it because of obviously what you say, but also it's the way you deliver everything. I mean, you are brilliant.
Like,
absolutely brilliant.
It's always very emotional when you speak because you talk about different things that we all deal with in life. You definitely evoke these kind of emotions in me, and I'm sure in so many other people that hear you speak, and you're special.
Thank you. Thank you.
You really are, Brandon. I think that you're doing exactly what it is you want to do, and that is moving people. And your words are so poetic, so in the moment. We're not only enjoying your performance, but the message is so clear. And thank you for moving us. And I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you guys so much.
Well done, Brandon.
That was really special.
He is special.
I'm so proud of you. You did so good.
Now you want to get back to mommy.
He's like a star.
I have to like fight with tears when he speaks.
He was good.